This is the new EOS R mirrorless system from Canon. Hi, this is Nino from Cinema 5D. We're here at IBC 2018 with Marcel from Canon, and we'll take a look at the new EOS R system. So Marcel, we're here at IBC 2018. This is the first time you're showing the new Canon EOS R system. Just to get our audience a quick reminder, can you give us a run through of all the features?
I'd say it's the biggest launch in 30 years since we started with EOS. Because we made some changes, this is the first camera with full frame. It has a new mount, so we need new lenses. But if you want to, you can use all the adapters to use your old EF lenses on it. And so they will work seamlessly together, and this is the first start into the new system to be future-proof for the next 30 years.
So this is a full-frame mirrorless system from Canon that we've been waiting for a very long time. Why do you think Canon took the time with this? Because a few years ago, I think, you know, there was still... The answer to that was still that photographers probably prefer mirrors in their DSLRs. Do you think that has changed over the past few years?
The market has shifted a little in the last few years. So by now it's about 50-50 mirrorless and SLR. So this is a quite good new start, and we wanted to make it right with the new lenses, so we had to take several things in consideration. So it's not only EOS camera built in a small body. It has several new features, and everything is thought through very well.
So as you know, at Cinema 5D, we are mostly interested in the video features of new cameras, even if they are predominantly made for stills. But we really believe in system cameras and to bring everything together in one camera. What can you tell us about the video features of this camera?
I'd say this time we listen to the customers, we have focus peaking in the camera, we have a flippable screen so that you can shoot yourself if you're doing YouTube, for example. You have the dual pixel autofocus, which is by now one of our strongest features. It's capable of doing 100% of the heights and 88% of the widths. You have face detection in it. Internally, you will record again with 8-bit, I know. But externally, you can go over the HDMI to a recorder in 10-bit.
I think the main question, you know this would be coming, why is there still a crop when you record? Video, and because also the question of course is the competition has had mirrorless cameras for years now that managed to record 4K without any crop.
Canon Inc. decided to do it either all the way or don't do it at all, because at the moment the crop is 1.74 and you will end up with a format which is similar to Super 35. But with using the whole sensor, the camera starts to heat up and sometimes your recording will be interrupted. And as long as we do not manage to get this under control, we will not do it, because we will never want the customer to have a negative experience with the camera not working. Besides this, it leads to a better rolling shutter behavior, and you do have less problems with moirés and artifacts if you have a 1x1 pixel readout, as we have now.
Okay, with regards to the really great Canon autofocus, which is objectively the best in the industry. As you know, I tested the Canon M50, and while it's a nice and small and also very inexpensive camera, for me the biggest downside for video was of course that you lose the dual pixel autofocus when switching to 4K. Is this also the case with the EOS R?
No, not with the new one. You can use full function of the dual pixel autofocus, so you will not lose it in 4K. You can customize it as you like, you can make it faster or slower, and even adjust how fast it will react on a new impulse or a new layer of this.
Another question, of course, for any video shooter important is to know if there is C-lock in the camera, because this is something that Canon did not put into a lot of their DSLRs in the past, or most of them actually.
Out of the box, it directly comes with C-Lock 1, so you can use it and mix it up with other Cinema EOS cameras easily, and it's easy to grade. So this is, I guess, what C-Lock was always famous for, that it was a really good, robust material which you can grade easily.
Most professional new DSLRs and also a lot of mirrorless cameras from other manufacturers have dual SD slots now, because this has kind of become a standard. Why was the decision made that the EOS R has only one?
To be honest, I do not have the reason why we chose to only introduce one slot. I know it is a start, so I guess more professional EOS R, which are in the future somewhere, will come with two slots. But you have the opportunity to restore all your footage immediately on your smartphone or tablet. Or if you come home to your home Wi-Fi, the camera will automatically connect and transfer all the images and movies to your computer or smartphone, whatever you want to.
Okay, so there's also Wi-Fi built in.
Yes, it comes with Wi-Fi and low energy Bluetooth so that it can stay connected all the time. And while you're not using the camera, and it will transfer the images to your smartphone if you like to.
Automatically?
Yes.
Okay, cool. Audio input, you have a stereo audio input. So of course, the first question is, again, we've gotten used to getting attachments, you know, to get dual audio input on mirrorless cameras from other manufacturers. First question, is there something like this planned from Canon? And second question, is there any way to separate the stereo signal into getting two sources into the camera so we can actually have two different sources?
So far we only have the built-in stereo mic, and you can use the head jack for headphones and microphone, but you can't separate the signals at this point of time. And about future products, as always, we can't tell anything.
There's a new sensor protection feature built into the EOS R. What is it?
If you switch the camera off and change the lenses, the shutter will go will close so that the sensor is protected from dust. And together with the new lenses and the new bayonet comes some new features. We have more connectors now, which leads to more functions. For example, that the image stabilizer is built in the lens, can talk to the camera, which has a gyro as well, so they can detect the movement better than before.
Okay, so this is the new stabilizer. Is there anything else to add how the stabilization works in this camera?
This is predominantly for photo, but as well you can use it for video. So you counteract small movements within the lens by the optical stabilization, and you have a 5-axis stabilization in video mode, which can prevent camera movements in any directions or rotation, and really counteracts quite strong against even slow movements when you're walking.
So your image is not cropped when you use any kind of stabilization?
It has two modes. The one mode that is already quite capable of doing rotation and tilt, and there's one dynamic mode which is stronger to protect you from movements from walking, and this will crop like 10% into the image.
Okay, let's stay with the lenses for a little bit. You also introduced a new range of lenses to go with these cameras. What focal lengths do you have, and what's different about the existing EF range?
So far, directly from the start, we will have a 24 to 105 millimeter with f-stop 4, a 35 millimeter with 1.4, 50 mil, which I have on here with 1.2, and really new lens, and what I really do like a lot is the 28 to 70 with a constant aperture of 2. So this is a benefit out of having a mirrorless camera. You can now design lenses which have better optical qualities, are lighter, just because you do not have the mirror in between anymore.
How is it backwards compatible to EF lenses?
Fully. So we decided not to skip the old system. So instead of we integrated it completely, so the camera will within 2018 always come with an adapter attached, and the camera is capable of speaking to the old lenses in the same language than before, so you have no translation delay or no functional limitations at all. So you can just use your old lenses as you always used to be.
Is the autofocus working just as well with the old EF lenses, or is there any difference in performance?
No differences at all, so you can use the full potential of the DAF. dual pixel autofocus. And as well, maybe quite interesting for video filmers, it will not only come with the standard adapter which just connects everything, you will also have the opportunity to get a circular pole filter and variable ND filters into the adapter, which you can adjust.
So that's a separate adapter or?
Yeah, these adapters will start in January, so a little bit later, but until then you have still the one that comes with the box.
Okay, cool. Thank you, Marcel.